April of 1945, the British forces captured several vehicles at the Henschel Proving Ground at Haustenbeck, Sennelager, Germany. Several of these vehicles were the immense chassis of the 100 Project, another big boy called the Grille 2 or the Geschützwagen Tiger, a Jagdtiger which had the rare Porsche running gear, and an FK-301 Henschel prototype that was made into an experimental trench digger, and two soft steel Tiger II prototypes. The Haustenbeck training area, or better known as the Senne military training area. This training area is sometimes referred to as the Haustenbeck training area because it was named after the village that once stood here in 1937. Like many other villages in Germany, it had to make way for Germany's immense military expansion, and it was demolished and the 1300 inhabitants were forced to move for the expansion of this area. Some were forced to move for the expansion. Some were homeless for 2 years until they were sent to temporary buildings or simply moved away and started their lives over. This large training area consists out of 550 hectares of land and would see testing of many German vehicles by Henschel, like the famous Tiger tanks and several of the FK prototypes. And one other interesting vehicle that was rigorously tested here was the FK-301. This vehicle was the further development of the Doorbrugswagen 30, or in just plain English, breakthrough wagon or vehicle, whatever you prefer. And I hear you thinking, I thought this video was about the Tiger II prototype, and I will get to that shortly. The FK-30 would eventually be cancelled in favor of the DW-30 project, and the FK that was found at the training grounds here disappeared to be later discovered in 1980s, but I'm going to talk about the FK project some other time in full detail. These two prototypes are the ones we are looking at today, and they are often mistakenly called the Porsche Tiger II. After the Porsche turret, due to the misbelief that these turrets were designed by Porsche for their prototype. In reality, both turrets were designed by Group and was designated early Group turret and would be replaced by a better design known as the so-called Henschel turret. The early turrets proved to be overly complex and expensive to make. Also, tests proved that the curved front of the turret acted as a shot trap, ricocheting shots that hit into the hull roof. But before this was all discovered, Group still made 50 of these turrets until they were replaced by the late Group turret. Both of these Tigers were never used in combat, and they were produced in a cheaper way with soft steel, and they had multiple differences for testing purposes. The first prototype had Simrad added and was outfitted with all of its tools, but the most notable thing is the broken gun, which was destroyed during firing tests. It also could close off its air vents, and there was a deep wading pot on the rear deck to fit a snorkel, so it could wade into water. You can actually see the British try the deep wading test area in this footage, but they eventually drowned the engine because it didn't have the snorkel fitted. If this was done intentionally or a mistake is unknown to me. The other prototype was basically the same, but was fitted without the tools and Simrad, and some of its suspension was incomplete. Also, all the fuel and pistol ports were welded shut, and it had modified exhaust pipes for testing exhaust pressure. The fittings for this can still be seen on the left side of the tank today. This Tiger II is of course the one from the Bovington Tank Museum and on loan to the Military Museum in Soest, the Netherlands, where it will stay until this summer. Future me here, with the current situation, the tank will of course stay longer for the time being. It's set to leave next year sometime in the summer. The tank is of course part of the Hayovik expedition at the museum, and that's been closed since the first day it opened. But have a look on the museum page for more information. After testing these vehicles at Haustenbeck, the Tiger, the Jagdtiger and the E-100 were taken to Britain for more testing. The Tiger and the Jagdtiger were sent to the School of Technology at Chertsey, Surrey. Note that the Tiger arrived there without a gun and some of its parts removed. And this is where the story of this tank gets a bit confusing, because multiple sources say different things. Some of the sources say that in 1952 the tanks were sent to Bovington, and in the late 50s the collection was cleaned up and the E-100 chassis was scrapped. I always found this to be the reason the external parts of the Tiger were probably sold off for money as well.
We've got to have money.
Something the Bovington Tank Museum most likely likes to forget about. Other sources say the Tiger II was still at the Tank Technology School. It was eventually restored with a spare gun of a later design and placed on display, but it's still missing several parts today. In 2005 the Maybach engine was eventually removed and fitted to the Tiger I 131 project, after multiple mistakes had damaged the original engine, but other sources say this also could have been done in 2010. It was repainted in 2015 for the Tiger Collection exhibition at the Bovington Tank Museum, which displayed the biggest Tiger collection at that time. And this is pretty much where the story of this tank ends. But I hope you enjoyed this look at one of the rarest tanks out there. And if you want to support this channel, have a look at Patreon or my merch store. And don't forget to like, comment and subscribe for more content. Stay safe and thank you for watching.